Hi students, welcome back to our video lectures. In the last class we have discussed about the harmonic distortion and the second harmonic distortion. Now in this lecture we will discuss about the power output due to the distortion, even the higher harmonic distortion, and then we will move on to class B power amplifiers. Now let us start our discussion with power output due to distortion. We know the basic formula for the power delivered to the load, PAC, which is equal to IM square into RL divided by 2. RL is the load resistance or load impedance. IM is the maximum current or the peak current that is going to be produced across the load. We know the formula for the maximum current, which is a peak current. Peak current is an average of peak to peak current, IPP divided by 2, peak to peak current divided by 2. We can calculate that the peak to peak current with I max minus I minimum divided by 2. And B1, which is equal to I max minus I minimum by 2. Reason is that in the earlier discussions we have already quoted B1 is the fundamental frequency component and approximately equal to IM. Now we replace this IM with B1. So we get it as PS is equal to 1 by 2. We replace this IM with B1, B1 square into RL. This is the basic formula for the AC power which has been produced due to the fundamental frequency component across the load. As we know that if the distortion is increased, the amount of a power delivered across the load is also going to be increasing, and it is based on the total harmonic component. Say this: the AC power output with the harmonic distortion, we will represent this is without harmonic distortion. The formula is PS is equal to 1 by 2 B1 square into RL, and the AC power delivered with distortion, which is representing with the PAC suffix D. D stands for the distortion. Now the formula is 1 by 2 B1 square RL plus 1 by 2 B2 square RL plus 1 by 2 B3 square RL and so on. This is what is the AC power that has been delivered, or output AC power that has been delivered across the load due to the first harmonic, or you call it as a fundamental frequency component. All these remaining components are the harmonic components, because this is the second harmonic component, this is the third harmonic component, and we have all other succeeding components of harmonic components that are going to be existing in the equation. Means this is our basic fundamental frequency component. All these remaining are the harmonic components which are involved to produce the harmonic distortion. All these harmonic components together is going to produce the harmonic distortion at the output side. You just take that fundamental frequency component as a common 1 by 2 B1 square into RL. You take it as a common 1 plus B2 square divided by B1 square, B3 square divided by B1 square, B4 square divided by B1 square, and so on. If we try to simplify it, this is the AC power, distorted AC power, which is equal to 1 by 2 B1 square RL into 1 plus D2 square. We know the formula for D2. D2 is equal to B2 divided by B1. See here, B2 divided by B1, which is a distortion for the second harmonic, and the distortion produced by the third harmonic is given by B3 by B1, and so on. The distortion produced because of nth harmonic is given by Dn is equal to Bn divided by B1. Likewise, if you try to write it, 1 by B1 square into RL into 1 plus D2 square plus D3 square, and so on. And we know this, we know the formula for the total harmonic distortion, D is equal to square root of d2 square plus a d3 square and so on. Now we replace this d2 square plus a d3 square and so on with d square. This is what is the total harmonic distortion. D square is equal to d2 square plus a d3 square and so on, where d is equal to square root of d2 square plus a d3 square plus a d4 square and so on. Now this is what is the total distortion that is going to be existing along with the AC, which is equal to PAC into 1 plus d square. As it is very much evident from the equation, as the number of harmonics are more, or the harmonic components are gets increased, the total or this distortion that is going to be existing at the output side is also increases, because this PAC is gets multiplied with 1 plus d square. This is what is the basically the power output due to distortion. If we don't have any distortion, you simply make this d is equal to 0. We don't have any harmonic components involved in the signal or in the fundamental frequency component. You can keep this d is equal to 0. If d is becoming as a 0, PDC or PSD is equal to simply PSC. We don't have any distortion due to harmonic components. Now let us move on to the higher order, or you can say higher harmonic distortion. So far we have discussed in the previous section only the second harmonic distortion. Now we will move on to higher harmonic distortion. We will go on increasing the number of harmonic components. We are not going to be restricting up to the second harmonic. Let us see what will happen if the harmonic components are gets increased, and how it is going to be affecting on the distortion. And we have already quoted there will be a non-linearity of the harmonic component, and even the harmonic components are gets increased, the distortion also increases. And we can write that fundamental formula for the collector current. IC is equal to, this one we have already seen in the earlier discussion. IC is equal to G1 into IB plus G2 into IB square plus G3 into IB cube plus G4 into IB4. This is only for example we are taking this. We can do it for any number of harmonic components, keeping the complexity in mind. Just here we are restricting up to IB power 4. And we know the base current equation, IB is equal to IBM cos omega t. You substitute IB is equal to IBM cos omega t. We rewrite this IC. Now just to substitute the basic formulas for cos square omega t, cos cube omega t, cos power 4 omega t, and you do the trigonometric operations, we will get IC is equal to B0 plus B1 cos omega t plus B2 cos 2 omega t plus B3 cos 3 omega t plus B4 cos 4 omega t. You need to do that simplification. How you are going to be getting that B0, B1, B2, B3, B4? They are all constants. B0, B1, B2, B3, B4, they are all constant, or you simply say the amplitude of the signal associated. You don't have any say cosine term here. It is purely a DC component which is involved, or you can say it is a constant or a DC component gets involved with your collector current. You can identify here G1 into IBM or G2 into IBM and so on. We are going to be getting the constants. All these are all constants. G1 IBM, G2 IBM square, G3 into IBM cube, G4 into IBM power 4. All these are all the constants. We are trying to write it as, after expanding that equations, you try to minimize or simplify it. We write it as B0 plus B1 cos omega t plus B2 cos 2 omega t plus B3 cos 3 omega t plus B4 cos 4 omega t. From the above equation, it is very clear that this is the fundamental frequency component, this is the second harmonic, and this is the third harmonic, and this is the fourth harmonic. This equation is totally consisting of four harmonic components. And we know the total collector current including the DC biasing. We know the operating point you try to apply to the transistor, ICQ, which is a operating point, the collector current due to the operating point Q, which is gets added with the DC component. Now the total DC component existing at the collector, IC is equal to ICQ plus B0. This is the total DC component, means it is a DC plus AC, DC, and the remaining all these B1 cos omega t plus B2 cos 2 omega t plus B3 cos 3 omega t plus B4 cos 4 omega t, all these are all AC components, DC component plus AC component. And we know that B1, B2, B3, B4, they are all the amplitudes of first harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic, fourth harmonic components. Now, let us go with the 5-point method. You see here the total number of elements we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, including one DC component, all the remaining are AC. Let us consider a 5-point method, what we have done earlier. Now, from 0 to pi, you need to consider, you need to take all the 5 points. This is at omega t is equal to 0. The next point we need to take, the point number 2, we need to take at omega t is equal to pi by 3. Third point we need to take at omega t is equal to pi by 2. Fourth point we need to take at omega t is equal to 2 pi by 3. Fifth point we need to take at omega t is equal to pi. Correspondingly, we have already seen this. At a point 1 we have I max, at a point 5 we have I minimum, at a point 3 we have ICQ, which is an operating point. Let us take this as plus half. From here to here we have a plus half, and here to here we have a minus half. Consider this I 1 by 2, I minus 1 by 2. This is what is the DC biasing value we have. Now let us move on for the calculation part. At the point 1, at the point 1 we have omega t is equal to 0, which is I max. You substitute omega t in the basic equation, whatever we have quoted, IC is equal to ICQ. We know the basic equation for IC. IC is equal to ICQ plus B naught plus B1 cos omega t plus B2 cos 2 omega t plus B3 cos 3 omega t plus B4 cos 4 omega t. Now substitute omega t is equal to 0 in that, and we know from the previous diagram IC is equal to I max. You substitute, we will get that equation as I max is equal to ICQ plus B0 plus B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus B4. Similarly, at a point 2, substitute omega t is equal to pi by 3 and IC is equal to I 1 by 2, and we will get I 1 by 2 is equal to ICQ plus B0 plus, you say, 0.5 B1 or 1 by 2 B1 minus 0.5 B2 minus P3 minus 0.5 B4. Similarly, you try to measure at different points by substituting omega t is equal to pi by 2. We get this equation, and omega t is equal to 2 pi by 3. We get this equation. At 0.5, omega t is equal to pi. You get this equation. And now we have 5 different equations because we have taken 5 points. It's a 5-point method. Previously, we have discussed 3-point method. This is a 5-point method. From this 5-point method, again, we need to calculate B0, B1, B2, B3, B4. That is what is a basic our aim. Now, this is what is B0. Basically, this is what is a B0. We can try to calculate B0, which is equal to 1 by 6 into I max plus 2 into I 1 by 2 plus 2 into I minus 1 by 2 plus I minimum. Likewise, you try to solve all the 5 equations what we have quoted here. We need to calculate B0, B1, B2, B3, B4. All these we need to calculate. And you want to calculate the harmonic distortion for any component. This is a well-known formula for us. The nth harmonic distortion, which is equal to the amplitude of the nth harmonic divided by the amplitude of the fundamental frequency component, or you can say it as a first harmonic component, which is a fundamental frequency component. Why we are calculating on this B0, B1, B2, B3, B4? You can calculate what is the distortion produced by each and every harmonic component. All these harmonic components are added together, going to be producing more amount of a distortion at the output side.